Hello, Internet. It's the news again with Haja Asif Khan, a show where the news is always terrible. Elon Musk has said this week that it's absurd that India does not have a permanent seat at the United Nations Security Council. What I find absurd about this whole situation is Elon Musk's interest in the politics of a world he's dedicated his whole life to leaving. International publication The Economist has seen a sudden drop in article submissions from unemployed armchair analysts and podcast hosts from Pakistan. The decline was noted after a senior military official revealed that the publication charges $500,000 to publish an article. More news on the news, as the editor of the Financial Times thinks the UK is on for a good year ahead because their wave of populism has come and gone.
End of the year, the UK is going to appear as one of the more stable countries because we essentially have gone through our era of populism.
Referring to Brexit. I think she missed the memo that clarified populism is a process and not an event. Or maybe she's basing her assessment on the fact that Britain has nothing left to Brexit from. Now, this statement was given during a talk at the World Economic Forum at Davos last week. The summit ended up becoming a backdrop for a number of interesting developments. The theme of this year's summit was rebuilding trust. There's so much you could learn from Eastern diplomacy here. Take the Pakistani and Irani delegates, for example, chumming it up at Davos. And this was all happening at the same time as the Iranian Revolutionary Guard Corps was gearing up to violate Pakistan's airspace in a unilateral move to neutralize militants. Not just that, but the Irani FM also went on to clarify at the summit that they did not target any Pakistanis, but the attack was actually aimed at militants. And Pakistani territory apparently just got in the way? Of course, Pakistan had to respond. So they took that very statement and used it as tactical guidelines for a retaliatory strike on not Iran, but non-state militants, and Iran's territory this time accidentally got in the way. Iran and Pakistan have resumed diplomatic ties, reopened airspace for each other's traffic, and negotiated more trade deals in the wake of this whole episode. The chairman of Pakistan's Senate Standing Committee on Defense has even gone on record to claim this is the fastest de-escalation of hostilities in history. I guess a little mutual destruction can be mutually beneficial for brotherly relations in the long run. Ask anyone who's grown up in a joint family. That's it for now. Tune in next week to see what's making the news again.